All right, hello YouTube. It's me, Evan Hillis, and today we are going to a factory where I'm getting some prints made for some of my paintings so that I can sell prints and different sizes and all that stuff. Thing is, this place is way out on the opposite side of town in a place called Huadu. It's on the far north side. It's about an hour away by metro. So it's gonna take a bit, but let's start with this. I'm gonna go pick up one of the shared bikes. They're all over the place. This is the blue one, which is the one I have. It's owned by Alipay. If you know Alipay, they're kind of like, you know, Alibaba is also kind of like Amazon, huge Chinese company. So I'm gonna open the app. You know how it works. Scan that sucker. Click that. I don't know what this is. Okay. Alright, and that works. Now, these things are pretty prevalent everywhere here. I know they kind of came and went in the US. They've also come and gone somewhat here, but they never really went. They just changed which companies were popular. So this is like the most, one of the big ones now that's stuck around. Mobike is pretty much all gone. And these other companies that already have stuff like Didi and Alipay ended up getting into the game later with much better quality bikes, and these seem to be sticking around now, so that's cool. Alright, so now we're heading to the metro. I'll see you in a few minutes. It's actually quite common to ride on the wrong side of the road here if you're a bicycle. Usually the rule is you just stick to the far side of the street. But it doesn't always work out depending on how many people are on the road. I'm obviously the only one doing it right now, but I assure you, there's plenty of other people that do this. There, you can see way up ahead there's someone.
Lock that sucker up.
You better lock it up. You better lock it up.
No, you lock it up.
Lock it up. Lock it up. Lock it up.
Here we go, into the metro. And the good thing about Guangzhou is it's a big international city, so we always have English, which makes it a lot easier for newcomers to travel around the city. So these scanners are just to make sure that nobody's bringing anything dangerous onto the train. They only implemented these in the last couple years, but they started in Shenzhen and then now they've spread to Guangzhou and I'm assuming most of the other major cities around China as well.
And then I gotta go buy a ticket because I lost my metro card. Usually you just scan the metro card, it's super fast, but I usually don't use the metro as much anymore these days, so I haven't bought a new one.
So there's a lot of new lines. We're going super far to line 14. And that's as farther than I've ever gone before. So I need to take a second to find out where I'm going. All right, cool. Going to
Zhu Liang.
And I can pay by WeChat, of course. So I just hit that, get the QR code. Scan that sucker. Hey now, I'm not gonna show you my PIN number. Okay, incorrect. All right, there we go. Comes out right here, that's my coin. So it's 3 o'clock in the afternoon right now. It's a pretty slow time of day. Although this does get packed at rush hour, I can assure you. Now these arrows here on the floor, these pretty much just make it idiot-proof to not know where to line up. The arrows pointing in is where you line up to go in, the arrows pointing out is where you're supposed to stand aside and let people get out. Unfortunately, not everybody follows these rules though.
Check.
The train bound for Tianhe Hong Street is approaching at platform 4.
And here I was, lining up for the wrong train because I'm a fool. And now I have to wait another 5 minutes for the next train. Ayah. So you see this woman behind me? This person is what I call the scum of the earth. Now that's a bit harsh, I admit. But it does still frustrate me that people still don't line up properly. They can see that the arrows are pointing to where to line up, and they see two lines being formed, and then they just decide that they're more important than anybody else, and they stand right in the middle. And then as soon as the doors open, you can see that she just ran right in without even letting the other people get off first. I'm sure she got a seat, but, here we are. And now we are two stops away from the next place. Eventually, I did get a seat. Starting to pack up.
Run.
Boonies.
Far outside of the main parts of the city.
But there's a lot of factories and other things out here, and Guangzhou is just a huge sprawling area, so it just goes on and on and on. But yeah, out here things are a little different. You're allowed to drive motor taxis, similar to Panyu, where I first lived. Panyu is on the south side. But you can't drive motorcycles in the city because of, I guess people were using them for crime, and so they banned them.
The factory is somewhere down there, so
check it out in a second.
Here are a line of motor taxis, all waiting to take whoever. Super fun, I would do it, but the place I'm going is really close, so no need to take one right now.
They're fun and dangerous. Adventure of living in China.
All right, this looks to be the place. Following this big ass truck. Anyhow. Oh, it's like a pretty new factory. It's cool. Basketball court over here.
This will be the first factory I've ever actually gone to. Yeah, they have me coming to check the scans that they're gonna do and make sure the color is all good to my standards, so no problems. Little do they know that I'm colorblind, so we'll see how well this goes. But I'll do my best. So we're here in the factory. We got a lot of things in this office building, actually. It's not just for printing. Here we're gonna color check some of my paintings. Looking pretty awesome there. And here are some of my paintings. Let's see. Got the snail one, this landscape one, a bunch of these all here. So they've all been scanned. And these ones here got scanned on the big one, the photo looks like. That's pretty awesome. So they're all in the frames. I wasn't sure if they were going to take them out or not, but yeah, it's good. Man, I have not seen one of these IMAX since like 5th grade, 6th grade. These are awesome.
Yeah, this place is super cool.
Now, this place is actually not just devoted to printing. It's an entire office building. This one room and this floor is devoted to the scanning and printmaking. So this place is pretty cool. They have a giant crane-like thing with a high-resolution camera on it that can take very detailed pictures. It also has four directional lighting to light up the paintings to give them a very clean and nice photo. Then, after they take the photos, they'll save it as a TIFF file, and that file will be a very large file that I can then use to take to any print shop to make prints on whatever material is available. You can print on paper, you can print on more thick cardstock, or you can print on actual canvas. And so this can make some really nice prints that you can sell, or that I will be able to sell on my website. So I'm really looking forward to that as well.
This is the master, the shufu, the hanhao, make the beautiful paintings.
Bye-bye.
All right, and we're heading out.
Well, that was cool. And now we're heading back home through rush hour traffic because it is now 5:30, so it's gonna be packed on that metro. So we'll see how it goes.
All right, guys. Well, thanks so much for joining me on that trip. It was a lot of fun and a cool experience for me, at least, seeing how sausage gets made, at least in the printing world, and meeting that super nice guy. He was awesome to work with, and got to practice my Chinese a little bit, which was cool. And that is it. We'll see you guys next time. All right. See you. Bye. Bye-bye, chickens. Bye-bye, ducks.
I hope you found that interesting. And if you guys are artists as well, you know, making prints of your paintings is a great way to sell some stuff for cheaper that you can make a little bit of extra cash on if people don't want to buy, you know, pay the full price for a full-size painting. So I definitely recommend you look into that if you're interested in that kind of thing. Here we are on our way back home now. You can see it is rush hour. It's 6:30, and this line, particularly line 1 and line 3, is one of the most busy lines, or some of the most busy lines. And this is an intersection where they both cross here at Tiu Xilu Station. So you can see here that it's just full of people. And thankfully, I'm just leaving the metro now, not going more into it.
As you can see, it's the time. Shite is packed in here. We're almost home, only one more station to go.